So today there was a brand new bundle added to the Warzone and Vanguard shop called Final Judgement, and in Vanguard in particular it says free with a digital pre-order of Call of Duty Vanguard, I mean Modern Warfare 2. Carve up the competition with the Final Judgement bundle. So this is a little confusing. I'm gonna be honest with everybody out there. It's a little bit confusing, specifically because when we look back to the past 3 years of content, starting back in BO4, actually, when you pre-ordered Modern Warfare 2019, Captain Price made his way into Blackout as a character. That was freaking awesome. That was the first time we saw a huge crossover like that happen. Then with Black Ops Cold War, we got a chance to play as Frank Woods in not only Modern Warfare multiplayer, but also Warzone. Then with the pre-order of Vanguard, we ended up getting to play as Arthur Kingsley in Black Ops Cold War and in Warzone. And now here with MW2, we get a skin for Lucas that's not going to matter because when MW2 comes around, no one's going to be using this character. The same can definitely be said about Warzone 2, because when that comes around, we're not going to have access to these skins or characters. So I'm really confused why they went this route. Maybe it's simply because it's not attached in any way, shape, or form, and it's more or less just, here you go, here's a gimme. But then here's the other thing. The Final Judgement bundle isn't even giving itself to players properly. Like, I can't claim it because I didn't pre-order the game directly through the game itself. Instead, I pre-ordered it on the PlayStation Store, so now it's registering as I don't have a pre-order, even though I definitely do. So I don't really know if this is a situation of because I personally didn't pre-order from within the game itself, that means I'm not actually going to get this bundle, or if it's just a situation where it's not unlocking properly for people who did pre-order and it's going to be coming at a later date. I don't know. Either way, I'm going to keep it 100% with you. It's just not a good bundle. I mean, it's just not good. Even if this was in the shop by itself, this is one of those bundles that I would look at for a second and be like, okay, and then move on with my life. I would never buy this for 1,500 COD points, and I don't recommend anybody else does either. So listen, I know that there's going to be people out there that say, stop complaining. It's a free bundle. You didn't have to buy it anyway. You're going to be getting it because you pre-ordered the game. The point is, it has nothing to do with Modern Warfare 2 at all. I mean, through all of the marketing material that we've been seeing so far for MW2, Ghost has been the face of everything. And since Ghost is masked, he could technically have had his own skin on Lucas. It could have been a Ghost bundle called Final Judgement, and things would have made a lot more sense. Maybe they could have even thrown in an MW2 emblem or sticker that you could put on your weapon. Maybe even a blueprint that looks recognizable to a weapon that would be found in Modern Warfare. I mean, we have plenty of really futuristic looking weapons, character skins that look like they just came right out of the future, like this one in particular. There was really nothing stopping them from adding a modern Ghost skin with all the bells and whistles, including night vision goggles, and just throwing that in the game. Or even better yet, they could have done a World War II version of Ghost, and they could have had that as an operator skin, which would have been completely unique to Vanguard and Warzone, because like I mentioned earlier on in this video, none of this matters when we move on to MW2, and that could have been the end of it. You know, Ghost maybe could have had some sort of operator skin that would have went along with what we had here in Vanguard. I mean, hell, if they really wanted to get technical, they could have added Price in his COD 2 form, and that would have made total sense. He could have been a brand new operator, had his own voice lines. It would have been interesting and unique, and that's just that we don't have that. So that's the end of it. In my mind, I feel like this Final Judgement skin for Lucas was made specifically because of Fortune's Keep and the fact that we have these, you know, opulent castles and different thing that's going on. And he's kind of like the executioner, right? Back in the olden days, there was an executioner and he's the one that wields the axe, which missed opportunity for an axe melee weapon, a big one by that. So I really don't know what's happening here. That's going to be free at some point. Hopefully it will start granting itself to people. Once again, do not buy the bundle. If you already pre-ordered the game, you are entitled to this bundle. So do not spend the 1500 points. That's not how you activate it. It will take your points. I guarantee it. And then they'll probably have to refund you your points if you ended up accidentally buying it. If you are a PlayStation Plus member, there is yet again another bundle available for those that wanted to get it. If you head on over to the Warzone application, you'll be able to find the Warzone Combat Pack. Expeditionary. This is going to give you a handful of items that includes double XP, an epic charm, epic sticker, calling card, a legendary watch, emblem, an LMG weapon blueprint, a legendary shotgun blueprint, and an operator skin for Halima. Once again, this is one of those situations where this is a PlayStation Plus exclusive, meaning if you're on the Xbox or the PC and you own a PlayStation, you come over and download it, you're not going to be able to utilize this bundle on any of those platforms. In fact, it's only going to show up on the PlayStation. If you are playing one of those other game consoles, you're only going to see a default skin when you encounter somebody wearing this outfit. It's really weird. If you're on Warzone and you head over to the store, you can also go down to the franchise store and you'll be able to find this particular combat pack. It's only going to be available for a limited time, and once it's gone for good. So before we close out this video, I just want to say one thing. There is still hope that we will get some sort of specific operator, like a COD 2 version of Captain Price, or maybe even a Ghost or something, appearing in Vanguard and in Warzone. And the reason I say that is because last time, with all of these previous years of bonuses like Captain Price and Frank Woods and Arthur Kingsley, they didn't come through into the game until late August. So there is still a chance that, as of right now, they're just throwing out this pre-order bonus bundle. And then eventually, later on down the line, they will add some sort of unique character. Arthur Kingsley didn't come as an operator to Cold War and Warzone until late September. So there's definitely time for them to do something. I just think it's really weird how they went about doing this, because it's not the first time that we've actually seen a paid bundle come as a completely free bonus. Last time in Black Ops Cold War and Warzone, it was the Ghost of War bundle, which gives you this amazing looking skin for Naga. And this gets nowhere close to that. I'm just saying. And that came after the fact that Arthur Kingsley was a pre-order bonus. So I think that maybe they're doing it backwards at this point. So they're going to release this bundle, then they're going to be doing another pre-order bonus in August, maybe in September. And then finally, maybe they'll add another pre-order bonus for those that get in and pre-order in the final, you know, 30 days before the game releases or something like that. I could be completely mistaken, but at least if they did it in that order where you got like a Ghost or, you know, a Soap or somebody in Vanguard, then you would get whatever this judge, jury, executioner, you know, Final Judgement pack would be. And then it'd be like, oh, hey, it's just an additional bundle on top of what we've already gotten. And I'm sure that people would still be like, eh, it kind of sucks. But at least then it was just like, oh, this is just additional on top of it. Okay, you know, why not? Free bundle. Now it's just like, what the hell? It doesn't really make much sense. But that's just my thoughts on the entire situation. I just thought I would share this with you guys and let y'all know that it's currently not working. Do not spend the COD points on it, because it won't give you for free. It will, in fact, take your COD points, so be weary on that. And I guess just be patient in the meantime while they try to repair whatever problem is occurring in the situation. So anyway, that's the video. Thank you all so much for listening to me rant today. If you got anything to add to it, leave it down below in the comments section. What would you personally like to see for a Modern Warfare 2 pre-order bonus? Is it a specific character? Would you like a specific outfit? Leave your thoughts down below, as well as a like on this video, and subscribe for more coming every day. And I'll catch you all on the next one. See ya!